Hi guys, welcome back. We're in Monza today for round 15. We're taking quite a straightforward lead in the championship now, so it's more a case of cementing our position rather than playing catch up like we had been doing. But we still got to push because we're not like really pulling away. We've just had a really nice run recently, so it's carrying that on as we head to the high speed circuit of Monza. Obviously, the actual Formula One's in.
At some point before qualifying, let's get our track acclimatization program complete. It'll help us identify any specific problem areas on the circuit.
Obviously, the F1's again in the
try to nail as many corner gates as you can. The faster you get through each corner, the higher the score. You'll need to deploy your DRS in the DRS zone as well.
Keep wanting to say Marathon.
Approaching the DRS zone, watch your MFD for the activation point.
Very, very fast. Lot to turn. Even in the open DRS. Straight with me, not straight. Which hasn't got the actual straight.
Are you alright?
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how the overtaking actually.
Great stuff. You've pretty much.
That was a weird one. I'm also starting a plan for next season. I haven't quite decided how I'm going to adjust the settings. As I said before, I want to get rid of flashbang. Probably going to get rid of racing line.
This test is all about tyre management. Try to control the slip through each corner and take extra care putting the power down at the apex. Faster, okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
That's what these meanings are. I don't like meaning more than I just did it. I've only spent half of these collecting. I'd like to address that, but we do seem to be fast, even though we're struggling a bit.
In this program, we want you to focus on fuel-saving technique. Lift and coast through corner entry to save as much as you can while keeping under the minimum lap time. Okay, test complete, and that was a very... This is the ERS management test. Hit the target time whilst managing your battery charge. The more efficiently you use energy throughout the lap, the higher you will score. Use your overtake button for maximum power, but remember, that will drain energy rapidly.
What do you have there about this game? It's really... straightforward, on. And it comes back to the fact that I guess the RE tree knows a bit. Place, yeah, it's great in like season one. Season two, if you get rid of the SP5 off, but other than that, it's basically maintaining the actual car. It doesn't seem to have more than about a 3-year plan on any of this game. I mean, you can run your championship for 10 years, but, like, what's the point? Nothing to prove. Whereas if you did something like that, you
won't have to go away. Okay, we need a few solid laps here to help us calculate a good race strategy.
Incrementally increase in parts. Car get better and better, the better the carbons are, the better you will. Parts can increase, that range of percentage. Better part, the amount is where it is, like, spend as much as you can. Try and get that back, but straight step out.
Okay, super job so far.
Another three attempts up. I'm getting faster and faster. The tire wear is way better than what this was predicted.
Tires, just give it everything. In this test, we want to make sure we can lap close to our rival's pace.
Right now, I'm not in check.
Test complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
Oh yeah. I was wondering what was making that weird noise as I came around that corner. It's because I got two sets of parts.
Remind ourselves of our top three.
already into the 118s. And that was with having to overtake someone. Fastest through sector 2, even with that overtake. Yeah. We're a second faster there.
Less than a lap of fuel now, the tank is empty.
Is playing Assassin's Creed, and the dog does not like it when she fights other animals. It's very upset. Whoa. Unless this is a soft medium race, just do it a soft medium. Because these soft tires are super duper fast. Where's my race tire? One attempt on the used pair. If I need to. Really saves some time, isn't it?
With qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves of our top three. Tom.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. Are you feeling confident that you can take your qualifying pace into the race? Was today a good day for you? What was the secret ingredient for your performance today? Appreciate your time.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
So there is going to be a rank change, which means we're now going to hold off on any investment. Could you want to read that note?
Let's run you through the...
With your podium last race, the team are hoping for more of the same, but with yesterday's qualifying performance, it could be tough. Good luck.
Weird strategy. I like that. Very sight face for the first leg.
Okay, the start was fine. Let's try and move forward.
Thank you.
That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
TV's gone off. This kind of thing that I need to get out of that. Just get my foot in because I need to know basically what's going to be next.
Excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down.
make that.
We're boxing this lap. Give us the best in lap you can. The car behind has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. Exit now. Only one stop to go. No. One stop left in this strategy. Overtake now, please push hard. Nice overtake.
I think it's a lot of people come back.
Trailing our teammate by 10.4 seconds.
Okay.
Bottas is out in front. To the car ahead is 5.4 seconds. Was a heck of an impact. Let me know you're okay. You've got a lot of spare energy. Use your overtake button. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy. Set.
Could still run to the end.
The car behind has boxed for the mediums. Car behind on the medium tyre. Caution. flag. Lando in the pits. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the softs. +1 lap of extra fuel. Fuel target +1. In this lap, push now.
and get one.
Stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Some information on Perez. They're retiring from the race. VSC deployed. The virtual safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down. Maintain a positive delta. VSC ending. We're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Track is clear. Green flag. Is high. Let's use that overtake button more. Our gap to the car in front is 2.7 seconds. Engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Okay, you need to get that position back. That was an illegal overtake. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Yeah.
don't want to do is trip over that.
There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. For second a lap, we've got an opportunity to look after the car here. We have 2 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap. Final lap of the race. Absolutely awesome. Just amazing. Well done.
A nearly flawless performance here. Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium. So, let's review the driver's standings. Thomas increases their championship lead. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
It's got to be Lando Norris, hasn't it? Smooth, confident and assured. I've got no doubt that he and his team are going to be over the moon with his performance today.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.
So I extend my lead, but more importantly, the team extend their lead. So it's looking better and better for the double. So my fastest lap was only a second and a half faster than anyone else can manage it the nearest, with Lando, who's on that
great
ultimate
work,
strategy.
Let's have your thoughts. Looking like a winner has emerged in the championship. Is it in the bag? You and your teammate took the top two positions today. Have you got the best car out there? Do you think that your close rivalry has helped you out this season? How do you feel seeing your teammate up on the podium? Appreciate your time.
He's now doing exactly the sort of job that we wanted him to do, which is finish second on the regular, help us take that Constructors' Championship. Okay, so we can finally hit our final level 3 objective. In terms of the R&D, that's not been announced yet, but we're not going to spend any more points unless that fails, just by the fact that we've already got a big lead and we want to start protecting parts.
You're not currently in a rivalry. Sooner or later, you'll probably be asked by the media who you consider to be your rival. Think carefully who you select. While you will receive a claim for beating them, you'll lose a claim if you fail to do so.
Does that one come in? Yeah. So the only thing we really want to probably improve is Lando's experience stats. That will help. But like these ones we could do. But we already got paid come on. Anyway, that was a good race. So at Singapore next time out. Should be interesting to try and manage. Might even tell us if there's a R&D issue. So anyway, maybe after this race we'll find out. But in the meantime, give us a like, give us a share, and we'll catch you the next time in Singapore. So anyway, thanks for watching guys, and we'll see you later.